Instantiate is a function which is used to create clones of game objects. This is commonly used in the context of cloning a prefab. A prefab is simply a pre-configured object which is saved in the project's assets. One such example might be firing projectiles from a launcher. Each of the projectiles would need to be instantiated into the game world so that it could be fired. In this example, we're using fire1 to trigger an instantiate function. The most basic form of instantiate simply takes one parameter, the object that we wish to clone. In this example, we have created a public variable called projectile, and we're passing this in to the instantiate function. However, this means that the prefab will be instantiated at its default position, which in this case is 0. And in our example, that position is the center of the world and the center of where the launcher is at the moment. So, when we press play, those projectiles appear at the center of the launcher, which is not what we want. Instead, we want to fire it like a projectile, so it needs to appear in front of the opening of our launcher. For this, we need a slightly different version of instantiate. This version of instantiate takes three parameters: the object to be instantiated, in our case the projectile prefab, and then a position and rotation to give to our new clone of the prefab. For this, I've created an empty game object that's been positioned in front of the launcher's barrel. We're using this by creating a public variable called barrelEnd, and we'll use the game object's position and rotation values to assign to the new clone of our projectile prefab. By dragging and dropping this new game object into my barrelEnd variable in the inspector, I can reference the transform position and rotation of the empty object and use those to assign to my projectile. So, when I press play and press fire, the projectile appears in the right place, but it just kind of drops, which is not what we want. We need to be able to affect the object that's created by our instantiation, in this case, the clone of the projectile. Normally, instantiate returns a type called object, but in order to fire our projectile and add force to it, we're going to cast that type to a rigid body. To do this, we're going to add asRigidBody after the instantiate call, and then store the returned value in a rigidBody variable, which we'll call projectileInstance. So here we set up a rigid body variable called projectile instance, and we set that variable to be equal to the object returned by our instantiate function. Now that we have a rigid body, we can use our variable projectile instance and address anything within the rigid body class. For example, add force. And again, we can make use of the transform barrel end to grab the direction at which we want to add force. We can then multiply by a certain amount. So when I press play and fire, my projectiles are fired off by adding a force to the clone that I create. Bear in mind that when you create many clones within the game, those things will still exist within your scene. So if you're doing something like this, you may want to consider writing a script which removes them from the world after a certain amount of time. Here, my prefab has a projectile destruction script, which simply removes the object after a given number of seconds.